Very good morning to you. It is a beautiful Monday, one where a certain team is patched at the top, and another one is waiting for the proverbial bottom-up approach. With their constant excuses of tumezoea, sisi tumejua tuko vibaya, moja waanze kushinda. Wakianza kushinda watakuwa na mdomo. Anyway, watuulize sisi, we have been through Louis Van Gaal, we've been through David Moyes, sisi tuko sawa. However, I don't know if you saw, everybody wafanya hivi, five, na mufanya hivi, ama ni inne, the pog. Hey, kazi safi sana Manchester United, ilianza vizuri sana, but, like we always say here, we, kuanza tu, munaweza anza, shida ni mwisho. As Tuga wana sema hapa, mwisho. Hey, mutakuwa wapi. It's, the Premier League is back, and so is a lot of other things. We want to get right into it. We have Isa, Tizan, Suwela, Ukosawa.
Kashambamba.
No, results notwithstanding.
I know, we are busy men, and there's a lot of stuff in this town. So, we're going to manage that. So we've been there, done that, and...
When did the business start?
Okay, Steven Shitera.
Asante.
Karibu sana.
Naona hata unawakilisha na Blue.
Captain Pulisic.
I'm glad.
Captain America.
Yes.
Alifanya mambo yake.
Mambo yake.
Na ako Team B. Sasa mkaka Team A.
Team A.
Apo sawa. The sports guru John Kianda. Uko salama. Kianda atonge. Akuto And of course Fred Arocho, karibu sana.
Thank you. Mie siwezi sema niko happy because I lost in Vihiga.
Yes.
That is KCB.
And Chindwendwe.
Yeah, for me the league is gone. Congratulations to Tusker. And yeah, I'm a sportsman. I'm a sportsman, and the way you look at Tusker, I don't see them dropping any other points. But what makes me happy is that on Wednesday, I'm picking my 3 points from FC Leopards.
Yes.
Kama kawaida.
Utendelea na project.
Kama kawaida.
Utendelea na project.
Uyu ujamaa anabadilika kama anabadilika.
Zezi na project tu.
Gani na gani?
Yani bora tumalize position fiti, bora tumalize position poor.
No, but what was expected? No.
2 weeks ago, Shitera, you remember?
Yes.
But we were still on the
line. Yomana nimeshtuka.
No, no, it's only a fool.
You see,
it's only a fool.
You see,
who doesn't change his mind?
Where did the race turn between?
You see, Arocho, that will kuambia hapa. You see, venye kianda na kuambia, sio lazima uambiwe kutanyesha na unaona mawingu. You see, wao ulikuwa unapinga as if. Actually, hata nikauliza, as we speak. Ndiyo muko drone point, lakini Tusker wako juu
because
wako na good.
Which fool should I deal with first?
Yani
hesabu. Which one should I deal with? The point is this, guys. First of all, KCB, as we are beginning the season, we were not expected to perform the way we performed. I'm not using that as an excuse, but
no,
guys,
no, give it to him. Arocho.
No, but ulika hapa, ukasema kwamba mabingwa ni KCB.
KCB have... exceeded expectations.
Thank you.
But two, what Thank again you need to understand, league na wenyewe. Na wenyewe ni two teams. That's kind of goma here.
No.
Yeah.
Na goma here. Wait,
let's
which are the teams there? Which are the teams?
That's 25 years.
Let's look at records also.
Yeah.
There is a game also showing up as we talk about it.
Una kumbuka kiburi at Rocha Kijanayava.
So let me tell you guys.
Akasema TV Higa ni point start.
Let me tell you guys.
What are they lacking?
Why am I congratulating?
You have come back in the Premier League na unapigwa na timu ambayo iko relegation.
Bana.
That is even worse. That is even worse.
But why didn't you recognize
when
that?
You play a team that is struggling to remain in the league? But all said and done, guys, Tusker has the experience.
Oh, I've realized.
No. Ni ukweli. You know, I'm a sportsman. Mimi simple na kwama.
I thought Trekking Kobenye is an experience. Ziko ameshin the league.
So well. But look at it this
way. That is what we were explaining to you. That we were explaining to you.
Okay, we'll have to.
That is what we were explaining to you 3 weeks ago. You seem not to realize, but I'm glad you
that
have finance realized.
And that is what I'm trying to say. Yeah, that I'm realizing that Sazingine, unaweza kuwa umeweka mayai. Ukaanza kuzihesabu.
But either way,
kapata,
but
kumbe ni mayai.
But either way, if they finish second, it's a win for, yes, for Zico.
Yes.
I think that will be his best ever finish
performance as a head coach.
Yeah, for Zico, by the way. So
no, he has done it with Gor Mahia.
No, as an assistant coach.
No,
assistant coach. He's going to be the main man.
Yes.
So I think he's going to, with that kind of performance, I'm sure that
it is just going to encourage us.
And the bosses actually would give him even more money.
Yes, we are preparing a gala for my boys.
Two weeks ago. Columbia, they have the money, they have the experience, technical.
But don't we have the money?
It is true, but I told him, this is Robert Matan. When Tusker lost two games in a row, back to back, Jamaka to pigeon line up, because I'm a point tattoo up, point tattoo up. Look at
Atanza
Kungalia, line up your task and you may back you. At Yapa, what a pig, what a pig.
Mukami was here.
Listen, guys.
We were almost convinced, but I was not.
Tusker lost their captain, and they're still doing it well. The last three matches, they've not played with their captain who left for Zambia. Guys, Tusker is a team that is composed. Tusker is a team.
But these things we said 3 weeks ago.
No, guys.
Let him finish.
Let me tell you.
Why are you repeating?
When we were traveling to Vihiga, I believe very well that we're going to win against Vihiga. But look at a Vihiga side that is currently struggling to beat Mathare United down there. So they are also playing a team that is...
So did KCB underrate?
We didn't underrate, guys.
What happened?
I think most of my players have not really been at this stage. Because this is big stage. When you are playing for the tournament, it's big stage. And at times they crumple. And you look at Tusker, you look at the individual players, the individual brilliance at Tusker.
But we told you.
For me, cannot be matched. You cannot match one for one for the players at Tusker and at KCB. But having said that, gentlemen, KCB, I'm really proud of my boys, and I believe that in the subsequent seasons,
yes,
we are now going to Sasa Toko to Meiva. We'll be ready for the big stage.
Well, now that
Swila amekwambia kitu hapa, ligi ni Gor ama Tusker, si ndio? Okay, from former FC Leopards fan, ni uchungu.
Ati you're a former?
Now,
and they are playing Tusker on Wednesday. Now, the only thing that will favor KCB in the coming seasons is they have the money to buy good players from the rival teams, that's FC Leopards and Gor Mahia, who are broke. And the reason why KCB, at least this season, will try fit is because
it's not a mistake to have money. You're looking at it like
that.
If
Gor and FC Leopards were to financially stable, this KCB story will be a thing of the past.
If
they didn't take advantage of that, I'm praying that Gor and FC get a sponsor next season, because any top player in this country will want to play for those two clubs. Yani ni stability ya pesa ndiyo mfanya KCB wako mali.
So in a scenario where Tusker...
But as long as FC and Gor still are still broke, they'll still buy their best players.
Okay, so in what you're saying, in a scenario where Tusker, KCB, Gor and FC all are financially stable, who do you think wins? Or how
Gor Mahia or FC Leopards?
Not even Tusker.
But I want to agree.
What are you saying?
Wait, I want to
look at this scenario. Yeah, FC Leopards are financially stable. Gor are financially
stable.
Which kind of a player will want to play for Tusker and KCB?
Hey,
Kianda. But Kianda,
it's
practical. I want to flip it.
If you flip it the other way around, what he said is factual.
Kianda.
On one point,
okay,
is that all the top players would gravitate towards Gor or Leopards. That's a fact. Two, the issue of finances is neither here nor there.
Thank you.
Just speaking, Gor have a shirt sponsor.
Yes.
Leopards have a shirt sponsor.
But they are so
disorganized. Their disorganization
should not be our problem.
Absolutely, that's not our problem. If they can't listen, Rabu,
you know where my argument
is coming from? If Goma here can't manage the 45 million they are getting that gaming farm, that's not our business.
Let me strengthen Kianda.
If all matters are now aligned, let's say they manage, kila kitu
but everything was aligned beginning at the beginning of the season.
Wait, it was aligned.
It's you to align it.
It's not your responsibility. Come align
you. Let me strengthen your problem.
You are all losing a point here. Let me strengthen Kianda's point.
Okay.
You see, since 2013, when Gor Mahia were financially stable, where was KCB? Where was Tusker? Number two, as Kianda says, during that period, it was between Gor Mahia was winning it in the Premier League. FC has made it also in the League Cup. I want to agree with that point very strongly, that a very stable Gor Mahia and a very stable FC Leopards, KCB or Tusker, will come nowhere near.
Hold on.
You see, this is a situation where you have taken an advantage.
Of what?
And you know, you see, mtu akiwa chini, unaambiwa usimkanyage, but hivyo ndo mmefanya.
But ni fault ya nani wako?
Okay, ni fault, we have talked on this show time and time again.
About the club management.
Ni fault ya...
You know you are forgetting something.
Ngoja kabla hiyo point ipotee. Number one, ni fault ya federation.
Okay.
Number one.
Number two,
ni fault ya manager.
How do you bring the federation?
Let me explain. Federation, ikianza, na nilisema hapa last week, ilianza kuzozana na Nzoias, Madares. You see, if you have a deal, put it on the table. Let the clubs agree to it. And then after that, what a sign.
Number two,
ngoja ni malize.
May I defend my lovely
kids? Before you defend.
Because Before you defend,
you have seen what we have been served by FKF in the previous weeks. Slapping Gor Mahia and FC Leopards with some unnecessary fines. You see, to me, a club like FC Leopards, na unajua kwamba inategemea hiyo pesa kidogo inapata, they were given the money, but it was slashed.
I think the financial
instability in Gor Mahia and FC Leopards is what has brought.
Hold on, guys. I need us to talk before you respond. I think we need to get some things clear here. First of all, while my qualms, misgivings with the FKF notwithstanding, I don't think it is their role to get into a club to manage.
Absolutely.
To manage your manage their
but I was no, for
no,
management.
No, hold on. It's okay. Relax. So, that notwithstanding, you see, we need to draw a line here because there is financial stability, and then there is uko na pesa, lakini manage. So are we saying that when these teams become, when they start managing their affairs correctly, because pia tukisema pesa ndogo na kuna 45 million, for example,
to give you an answer,
you cannot sit here and tell me that Mwendwa has no role.
I'm not saying he has I'm just saying he has a role, yes, but we can't blame him wholesome.
Absolutely.
Their clubs are
see, Rabu, but why was the league flourishing under the Kenya Premier League Limited?
The league wasn't flourishing. It was a farce.
It wasn't built on anything.
Yes. And I can tell you for a fact.
I think these people
SuperSport pumped in. Listen, Raburu. SuperSport pumped in lots of money into KPL. We had a gaming firm that was pumping lots of money. The KPL Limited has zero assets that I can tell you for the last 10 years out of this partnership we bought this one.
Yes, they were just
nothing whatsoever,
swallowing everything.
It's just officials were flying to South Africa for some seminar everywhere, spending 5 million, what have you. Nothing whatsoever.
Let's not even mention KPL here.
So, because they were
when is the last time a corporate team won?
Okay, Oburu, may I respond? I've been bashed, guys.
Okay,
we are forgetting that
then we start talking about the other.
Wait, guys, wait. We are losing a point here. KCB was just promoted 2 seasons ago. You know, we are forgetting.
Sofapaka was promoted.
Wait.
That's not
a net. No, the point, give me my time. KCB was just promoted 2 seasons ago. Guys, it's a team that has been having a ton of coaches, 4 coaches in 2 seasons. Now, this season is the only season that we've had that stability of having ZDK Otieno Zico as head coach. And we've seen the stability that is brought into the team. Guys, you might have money and you're so disorganized. Gor Mahia, at the beginning of the season, had their 45 million. They are 60 million or so. FC Leopards had their 45 million. It's what they bargained for. So let's not say that it's because of the financial stability that is at KCB. Wait.
My question I've asked, that disorganized Gor Mahia has won the title for the last 8 years. Where was KCB?
That is what I'm saying. We've been having a turnover of coaches for the last 6 years. We've ever had about 8 coaches. That is what I'm saying.
And you had the money.
And yes,
that
was disorganization. But hula, we now have a stable coach.
You have not
reached the point. Okay, what? Yeah, and then we can move forward.
Argument yote unajivendea. Unajua kwa nini nacheka? Kwa sababu imeenda nje ya line. Mimi nilisema
wacha niongee kwa Kiswahili
kwa lugha
ya kwamba if KCB are given an option, if Tusker are given an option, wote Brewery itakuja sponsor FC,
correct?
KCB ita sponsor Gor,
toka hapo
itapata value kubwa.
Nakubali.
Ukweli wa Mungu.
But
no. Entered them. In the story, ni disorganization FC na Gor. That's why we always attract fire.
This is why this is my point.
Okay. So to shout
na don't
argument. Make the point.
Andraburu ulikuwa na drive vizuri until Arocho anza kuenda hivi.
Na number 2.
A stable
number
2 FC Leopards. Na sijasema ati wako stable. United. A stable FC Leopards. I financial table Gor Mahia, I financial table FC Leopards, every player, every good player in this country will want to play for those two clubs.
Period.
Hiyo ndio ilikuwa argument, tusonge mbele.
But what I'd like to know about tusonge mbele, what is mentioned KCB 17 times. You know, at the beginning of the season, nobody
the one who started.
Wait, what is going on?
I guess now we've talked about Gor and everything, so we just basically move forward from that and at least celebrate. Not celebrate. Let's throw it back a little bit and see what our government is doing in terms of welcome.
Probably. I don't know if for us the league table would benefit.
Which one? For KPL?
KPL. Maybe you better project it if we have.
We can give time to look for it. Gor was held by Bidco, and we'll see once it's ready can tell us and put it up. But boy, going into football,
who is getting relegated?
Something happened. Yes, something happened. We'll talk about that. Something happened that I think you should talk about, and will be overtaken by events because our Olympic heroes came home. The way they were received versus the way M7 received them or us, because some of the runners are Niwetu, it was a little bit of a contrast. And the argument given was that kulikuwa na COVID protocols that must be observed. And then when the others came, there was a better reception. I don't know what you people felt about that. It was a conversation online for a very long time. The tax notwithstanding. What do you think about that?
I don't want to blame the government here. I'll blame NOC. They're the guys who organized this entire trip. You need to have organized the trip from the word go, from the day we leave Nairobi, we go to Tokyo, and the way we come back. Mm. Guys, yes, we can blame our government, but give credit where it's due. The government did its job for the reception, for the fact that our players had their kits on time, their allowances on time, and NOC were even facilitated with cash to try and do all the miscellaneous that they needed to have done. Guys, what are in a government? Museveni just...
But NOC is the government agency.
No. It's the... Okay. That is... Okay. We don't want to blame the ministry as such.
Okay.
Museveni saw a gap, and you even heard him say in his speech, he saw a gap. He took the advantage. So, it for me, I don't want to blame the ministry or the minister. I want to blame NOC.
Well, his motivation notwithstanding, he did something admirable.
Is
it not so?
Yes, he did a good stuff. And even look at the first lady. Mm. You know, Jama, there are certain small things that go a long way. It's not even about money, how much you give me, but the way you appreciate me. Look at the first lady, the way she's appreciating. Since he went to
The picture that is on the... Tunaweza iweka. Yes, thank you, bro. Yes, that one, huh?
For me, Uganda scored. We might have done well as far as medal standings are concerned, but as a country, look at what he said. He had given a promise about, is it 15 years ago, that whoever wins a gold in the continental assignment and the world assignment will get some money. In fact, he has backdated that. They are going to get that money in arrears. Once again, Museveni.
And actually, to pick it up from you, and I follow it very closely, those who won gold medal from this assignment
in Uganda
will be earning around 114,000 Kenya shillings monthly.
That's for the rest of their life.
Yeah, to say thank you.
Oh, wow.
That's around 5 million Tanzanian equivalent. Those who won silver,
Kenyan.
the money will trickle down to around 85 or thereabouts.
Per month.
Those who earn one bronze around 35,000 per month. As a token of appreciation. Apart from that, you saw those guys drive away with very slick cars. They're living their dream. They never imagined this was tenable in an economy like Uganda. Now, for me, the take home for me is not even those vehicles that they drove away or those stipends they've been given. My major concern is Uganda bagged four medals in Japan. Look at those guys who won those medals. Cheptegei, the other lady. All those guys train in Mount Elgon on the Kenyan border. And they've been learning our tactics, training
under
coaches. They are us, as you said.
Yeah.
And they know very well that competing in Team Kenya and getting a slot to go represent the country in this international championship is cutthroat. It's very, very difficult. So if I have an option to choose between Kenya and Uganda, I'll choose Uganda, where my chances are almost 100%. On top of that, I'm sure if I win a medal for Uganda, there's a red carpet welcome for me. While in Kenya, our own Kipchoge Eliud, he's a global
ducking icon, under
came in the curve of darkness with just a few family friends and relatives there to welcome him. It was a big shame.
We don't know if that was their preference. We are yet to ask them. Maybe while
you cannot prefer to come in.
No, I'm just saying.
We are talking and bashing a government that really released the players in very high spirits. You remember what the president did to them. You see, we are comparing the returning and going. Why didn't we see Ugandans flagging them off? We saw President Uhuru Kenyatta flagging our team off. Why are we not talking about
that? That's a customary for every country. But now,
what I'm saying,
you must get a flag from the head of state because you are going to represent the country.
But what I'm saying,
so even if it's not publicized or not, these are a procedure worldwide.
But what I'm saying is, I will give an analogy. Mutu ambaye meenda kwa buffet. Kuna mwenye ataenda kwa buffet achukue some few veggies, chukue a piece of meat.
Kuku, yes.
Kuna mwingine atajaza mpaka afike huko kwa dessert, aweke yote. That is what is happening. Kenyans, we are used to this. We have celebrated until it is normal.
That's where the problem comes.
So to me, I agree with.
But let me give you an analogy as well.
Yes.
You see, if you are sasa mumewana,
yes,
I have some experience.
Yes.
And you stop appreciating that person at kwasabu anafanyanga tu na kwanga hivyo. It will end in premium tiers.
But
we made certain strides. There were records that are broken. We made there were new guys kina Omanya.
Yes, it's not like these are the same.
Yes, it's not the same.
But again, in your own analogy,
huwezi
linganisha wewe umekaa kwa nyumba kwa mwaka. Unajua mtoto akikuja, mtoto atachukua some portion of your love. So mama ile hata kupatia 100% kinyume na mwenye amefanya harusi hiyo usiku. So utalinganisha mtu ambaye yako honeymoon Mombasa na wewe ambaye mumekaa kwa nyumba 3 years. It will be totally different than analogy works.
No, it, well, to some extent, but still, you can't take it as usual. We took it as usual and we lost some of our key matches.
Uyu Kipchoge hizo magari munasema wamepewa. Amepewa like 30 of them.
Na nani?
Raburu.
Amepewa na a company.
In Kenya.
Yes, he was a company.
In Kenya.
But not the government.
In Kenya.
It's quite different.
Facilitated by a good environment. Government.
Check your look at
objectively speaking. Objectively speaking, let's treat this seriously. In any serious nation,
yes,
there's an award scheme for heroes and heroines. That's what happens worldwide in civilized nation. Today, if you go to the US or Japan or wherever or Jamaica, it's there.
It's like heroes welcome.
If you bring honor and glory to a country, there is a reward scheme on how we are going to treat our show as a hero or as a heroine. It's lacking in Kenya. The Sports Act is silent on this. Yeah? And that's why you see during Madaraka Day or Jamhuri Day, depending on whom you know at State House or at Avenue, your name is included there as a hero. You saw it with the Githeri man, and it brought a lot of backlash. And so by the way, this is an easy, a light issue. We need to treat the serious it deserves.
That's right.
And probably this is a wake-up call now on Amina Mohammed and even Joe Kudo. Can you formulate this? How are we going to appreciate our heroes and heroines on the track and the terraces and what have you?
They have a chance.
Still staying on
October 20th. But to some extent...
Mark Omanyala, just hold on, Shitera. Omanyala, you saw what he did in Tokyo. Yes. Even if he failed to win a medal, he's now a very good ambassador.
And recently he did...
At the weekend in Austria.
Yeah, he broke his own...
He ran under 10 seconds, under 10. Actually 9.86.
That's right.
So this is somebody that the ministry really needs to know. How do we tap onto Omanyala, even to market brand Kenya? How to market magical Kenya? Eliud Kipchoge, even if he wins 20 races, it doesn't matter. If the reward scheme says for every goal you're taking home 10 million, give it to him. It doesn't matter even if it's 100 times. So we're getting it wrong there. And the policy makers really need to have to wake up and formulate this.
What?
Lastly, Marco Tieno again. You saw what happened in Tokyo. And right now, Athletics Integrity Unit actually have opened disciplinary proceedings. So chances are, I believe he's going to be given a chance to defend himself. If he proves himself, he could walk scot-free. But there's a real peril that he could be sanctioned. We don't know how long. So even as we celebrate our heroes, again, NOC, Athletics Kenya, still needs to go out there. Sensitization campaign. You see, today, if I fail a doping test, it doesn't mean that I went there and took that drug intentionally or injected myself. At times it's ignorance. You just walk to the chemist there, I'm feeling maybe fever or headache, and I buy a tablet from a pharmacist there, and I take it, only to realize that some of the samples in that particular drugs is not permissible under the AIU expectation. And just like that, you fail the doping test. So a lot of awareness is needed, sensitization. And again, these athletes also need to know. And that's why they need to have wale wapishi wanaitwaje, and even the medics.
Nutritionist.
Yeah, whatever you're eating, don't just consume anything, Raburu, because now you're a top athlete competing at the top level, and a lot
there's
of
a requirement of yes.
And that's why most of them have failed this test. Where? Out of competition test. Because they simply call Kianda, where are you? We want to take your sample. But because he feels probably have consumed something, Kianda will tell them I'm in Nairobi. Yet is in his Funyula home or Nzoia or whatever.
Nabikoto.
So if it can't add up, that's what we call way about faith.
What I need to agree with all of you is we have some serious job to do. But again, where the government has done well, let us celebrate the
yes.
government. Because to me, I have been a journalist for quite some time. I have covered sports for a long time. Mm. And I've seen how we have received our athletes at the airport. You remember the msemo ya tayarisha dancers?
Mm.
It came from how we used to welcome our athletes. And I want to agree with the government that in the current times that we are in, where we are fighting a pandemic, let us not take it. Let us not take it lightly, as you might think.
After the cry,
as you might
pandemic leave.
No. Let us treat the times we are living in as extraordinary time. Let us not risk anything. By the way, on a serious note, I think some lapses are the ones that bring trouble in our zones. So I want to agree that it might be the COVID-19 protocols, because you have seen even how Harambee Stars have been welcomed.
Okay, the problem with that is the same government you're defending.
Surely.
The same government you're defending, when there was a lot of hula-baloo online, when the next batch came, all of a sudden there were the sisal scats and the people there. What happened
question.
To COVID at that time?
Let me ask a question. What makes you guys think the government is not planning anything?
Yes. And just because
I'm not a big fan of the government.
And then number two, Kianda, Kipchoge amelalamika, that he was not received. You see, let us leave it. Those people.
Okay.
Maybe as you say, Kipchoge is a very humble man. Na mnajua. Alisema musishugulike, nafika saa saba usiku, ni curfew time. Don't worry. Nitakuja sasa kama flight ya Kipchoge ilikuwa ina land saa sita usiku. Because I have that information.
Arocho ungeendo kwa
life. Na ni curfew time. So you want to break COVID protocol?
Hata niseme hivi.
Yes, Kian.
Tukimalizia. Babu kuna.
Toka hapo.
Mimi nasema hivi. No one has said
that they're not
the government is not planning anything.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sindio?
Eh.
Hii ni pressure tu mnajaribu kutuwawekee.
Wana extend pressure social media.
Tunajikombea na Uganda aje story athletics.
But they treat you that
no,
is the
truth.
At because you don't Uganda need
so, mjuni wa kwanza ukipata mjuni wa kwanza.
So
bila Shitera amesema utakuwa
possible.
Lakini ukifika namba 5 huko like mama aenda tutapata nyama.
So why is
yes, a rare moment once again where Kianda is attempting to agree with Shitera.
So
no he has agreed.
The fact that tunajua vizuri Swila, Arocho, Shitera, Rabur. Kama hii team ingekuwa mistreated wakiwa huko yego angepiga nduru kwa social media.
Thank you.
Sindio? Look at the way the government supported this team in terms of preparation.
I have that's okay.
Walifanya kazi yao.
We arrived to what
Paua. No, listen.
That no one has said
you're talking
the government
about proper
not.
Structured reward scheme, which is
it
lacking.
It is okay. The government
that's
is planning something.
Language.
Who told you that you are going to
do
it? Kipchoge mwenyewe, Jeff alijaribu kumtafuta kwa show Wednesday. He told him, schedule yangu iko very tight. Too tight.
Omanya lali land na kaondoka.
Ametoka.
Okay, so.
So, what
how do you receive
okay.
someone who is
in
really getting out?
Allow me to try. Kila kitu ilifanyika fiti.
Lakini watu.
Sini unataka kuwakemea tu.
You see that?
You guys are
right now.
Hold on.
Kianda. Now
hold
that
on.
Is the difference between Kenya and Uganda. Kenya, Uganda, they have time to celebrate. Kenya, Omanyala is landing and is jetting out
right.
for another
okay,
time.
Celebration should be.
So how do you celebrate
where
someone
where
who
is getting out? Wata nikulize.
Lazima tipa.
Arojo nikulize. Ungeenda live huko?
Naenda.
Ako si yako na pass.
Naenda.
Si angeenda live?
Si yako na pass.
Pata ki complain kila kitu.
Okay.
Gava ili play party ya haki.
What we are going to say
in this,
right? Let's
moment.
Here's what we are going to do. We are going to say this, okay? Like you said, we only have a we're not saying that. By the way, since you're to say me, tumetoka mbali as Shitera told you, I've also been a journalist for a long time. Tumetoka mbali sana. The government has indeed put its best foot forward this time. Mm. And for what it has done, applause is necessary.
Mm.
But for that, just that small part of appreciation. And even watch hata kutokea kwa airport, the bigger thing should be what Sula is talking about. What is the reward scheme? Like you said, let us wait. Maybe tunalima tu,
yeah.
And they are planning something. Wanakasa hii, wanatuona, wanasema, akia watu wangejua tu kitu tunafanga.
Yeah,
let's give them time. Let's give the government time. Let's wait
okay.
and see what plans are
okay.
there.
Yeah.
We'll still be here, God willing.
Yeah.
So let's give the government time and let's see what's going to happen.
That's
let's move
okay.
forward now to Europe. Hey, where?
to come.
The opening game on Friday, ilikuwa inapambana sana na Tottenham number 10, but it made me very happy.
But you are still top.
It made me very happy. But I am genuinely concerned because I saw the post you wrote here, Emmanuel Petit. I've seen the even own Arsenal fans on the timeline. You know, it has moved from EO to Nachapa and Nini to actual genuine concern. What is the problem? Do you think Arteta is going to last this season? Because his style of play, even on that Sikuya game, yani mtu anatoa striker. Lakini Arteta. Anyway, do you think really, especially as in Kianda, what's going on? Because the next matches you have, I don't know in what order, but there is Chelsea, there is Tottenham, and there is Man City.
You know, if you listen to Hot 96, which is the home of the latest sports update.
Yeah, man.
Woot.
Yeah.
So Arocho.
Yes, yes, yes.
And I pass the first hand information.
Yeah, I love when I pass over. You know, on Friday, on Kijiweni on the Citizen, I know Shatta wasn't there, but I really differed with Mukala. Mm-hmm. And Mukala, the good thing is, you admit well, bro, Arsenal is an average team.
Thank you.
Arsenal will not compete for anything.
Thank you.
I've been there for long.
Thank you.
Tumezeeka.
You also have experience.
Yeah, my good friend is called Elisha Nabwile. We were with him yesterday and he told me, "Ay man, game ya kwanza mtatoboa this season." He's a Manchester United fan. I was like, "We are not competing for anything."
Thank you.
That squad is just too average to compete. No. It's very unfortunate.
The
squad, the manager. You know, when you're fighting for a title, you have to look at who are your competitors. No. ni nani competitors wako? Hii squad ya sinaweza compete tu French League 1, ma German Bundesliga huko, ama Italian Serie A, ama huko wapi kungine, La Liga. Hata La Liga watateseka. But the averageness in that team and the unwillingness of Stan Kroenke to improve it, iko high class. So this season, man, itabidi tu tuende, tuanze tu kuangalia wakina Henry huko, walikuanga haji, unajua those days, nini. Look at the way Chelsea have strengthened their squad. And this, that team is so settled and disciplined. Enye Thomas Tuchel ameingiza kwa Chelsea. It's not a team you'll want to play. Look at Manchester United. They strengthened squad, yeah.
Thank you.
Though I know one thing, they will not win anything this season. Okay. Look at Manchester City and the way. Look at Manchester City and the way. Look at Manchester City and the way they are looking forward to sign Harry Kane. Your team ni mbaya. Look at Liverpool, the way they've come back. In fact, the good thing about Liverpool is wanajaribu wataki kusign. Wanataka players wako around wa settle. Van Dijk signed a new contract. Alisson signed a new contract. Fabinho signed a new contract. They're negotiating with Anderson. So ni timu zimeseto. Tottenham, Nuno Esperanto, all of a sudden, si atu watafight for the title. But, you're looking at the teams zenye Arsenal inafai pige, ni Rudy Champions League. Bro man, ningori. The good thing we celebrate this season, as Arsenal fans, is United will win 5-6-4, nini, but they'll take those screenshots. Because they'll need them at the end of the season, they will not win anything. They will not win. Just like December, we were top of the table. Yes, that's the only thing. And 6 points to Arsenal, 6 points from Chelsea, then the season is over.
And Man City.
But Everton, look at Everton, the way they played. Man, unakaivu na ulizamutu. The good thing I nilichaza say Friday, nilivaa jazi. Ya Arsenal Friday.
Na jumper.
Mchana. Ah, mchana. Baridi ilikuwa mingi singeza kutoa jumper. Lakini usiku, nilikuwa tunapata. In fact, wife yangu ndiye alikuwa ananiambia. Man, yani hii sizo tena meanza kupigwa. Support Liverpool. Meanza na kupigwa na timu kutoka championship.
At the beginning.
And look at the next fixture. Look at the next fixture. It's bad. Nothing.
So
to manage to expect. Hakuna hata kumanage expectation.